Toastmaster Rajkaran, I will return your compliments because you are also a multi-talented person in Toastmasters, donning so many hats. So let me reciprocate your sentiments. Fellow Toastmasters, esteemed guests from wherever you have connected, and distinguished guests, good evening. Many of us have often found ourselves say, it's too late to learn. It's too late to pursue our dreams. I think I've missed the bus. In fact, only last week when I was talking to my wife, who was complaining about the fact that I didn't provide her with a car and a driver at her parents' place, I said, well, you should have learned driving. It would have been so easy for you now. He said, no. It's not possible at this age. So very often we tend to think that we are too late to do something. And that is when I always recall the story or the life story of two personalities. One, Colonel Sanders, if you know him, the founder of Kentucky Fried Chicken. He was a failed entrepreneur and businessman in his early life. Whatever he touched was a failure. He had a motel business that failed. He started some other business that failed. And then finally he said, let me start selling fried chicken, which also had no takers initially. You may not believe it, that he produced 1,009 recipes. And it was only after that that one recipe was really selected by a franchise. And now KFC is history. Talk of Harry Potter. She was born in 1965, a journalist, but she tasted success not till she turned 32. And boy, when she turned 32, there was no turning back for her. So the thought today is that we are never too late to do anything. Even in Toastmasters, it's never too late to join Toastmasters, and it's never too late to achieve all the dreams that you have set out with when you joined Toastmasters. So I think on this positive note, let us all carry on our journey in Toastmasters wherever we are. And with that thought, I would like to invite some of our guests who have joined in from various parts of the world to tell us how they happen to know about our club, what brought them here, and to listen to a few of their thoughts. So first up, I would like to invite my very good old friend, Toastmaster Omar Farooq. I suppose he is joining in from Saudi Arabia, unless he has traveled or he has moved to some other part of the world.
Yes, I am still in Saudi Arabia, stuck there. So traveling restriction and also, I cannot go to Pakistan. We are in 79 Saudi Arabia, also the asset of 31 Division F of District 79. And I was invited by Pragya. So and okay. I thought that I have never attended a meeting of Mumbai to a small club-based clubs and all. So I thought it would be a great opportunity to get along and network with you all also. So I am a senior internal auditor by profession, working for Renault Automobiles for past 8 years. Actually, belong to Pakistan. Great to be part of this meeting. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Omar. I think the sergeant at arms in your club would also be finding it very difficult to introduce you with your long list of achievements. Okay. May I now call upon our other guests, whoever would want to come in? Varun, Manoj, Ganesh, Hitesh.
Good evening, everyone. Myself, Varun. So I'm based out in Mumbai only, and I'm a banker by profession, and I've been
Hi, so good evening, Toastmasters. My name is Hitesh Sindhwani. I am a banker by profession as well. I work for Kotak Mahindra Bank. I live in Mumbai, Powai. And incredible opportunity to be part of this club. I was associated with Toastmaster earlier, once in Pune and also in Noida. Didn't come around to joining Toastmasters in Mumbai at all. Given the lockdown and it was on here, I decided to make most of this. I find Toastmaster to be an incredible
late to join or to rejoin Toastmasters. Welcome to Bombay Toastmasters.
The Gulf. For about 5 odd years, I'm from Calcutta. I've traveled across the country, traveled around the world as well. There is a club in Bangalore, the Hoodie Toastmasters, and he invited me as a guest over there. That was quite an interesting experience, listening to all the different people talking about different topics. I also happened to speak about one of the table topics. So it was that made me think about finding out about the Toastmasters clubs over here. And one thing led to another, and I ended up getting in touch with Manan. I don't see him anywhere here. But he then added me to the group. So thank you very much for having me. I look forward to to this enriching opportunity, to this enriching chance to my overall development and growth. So thank you very much, and a very good evening to all of you.
Thank you very much. It was a lovely introduction, but I will not as an icebreaker speech. We'll have it for some other time. Okay. One last guest, Manoj.
Yeah.
Can you hear?
Thanks, Babu.
Yeah. Can we hear?
It's my pleasure to join this Pratibha and it's the topic if it turns out positive or negative, then some good books, and the drive for that would be generated from this discussion. So that's why I joined.
Thank you very much. We do hope you are reporting.
I'm a technical person and I work in a manufacturing sector.
Okay. Thank you for coming, and welcome to all our guests who are here today. And now let us move on with our session. Let me introduce the person who will take us forward. at the meeting today, 338 meeting. Let me introduce her a little differently from the normal conventional way. I will introduce her by the first alphabet of her name. Is it all right, Pratibha? Okay. Here goes. P for passionate. R for restless. A for assiduous. T for talkative. I for indomitable. B immediate past president of Bombay Toastmasters and currently an area director in Division B. Please put your hands together for the charming past president Pratibha Kamath. Over to you, madam.
Thank you. Thank you, Babu, you are mute.
Yeah.
Thank you for your kind, innovative introduction. It's on the type of smartphone and something creative, something innovative. Welcome to this Toastmasters meeting. It's my privilege and pleasure to welcome you all for this 338th meeting of Bombay Toastmasters Club. I'm very happy to see so many guests, our few old members like Kasim, also some new members, Pragya from Hyderabad, and she also invited someone from Overseas Club. Happy to see you all together at Bombay Toastmasters.
Maybe a lot of people are in quarantine or maybe in the under lockdown working from home, so they have a lot of time to read also. I take out time for habit. So great leaders are reads. So
wow. Yes, Hitesh, any idea?
Sorry, I was speaking on mute. I think the opportunity is incredible because everything has become digital. The wealth of information. Do you hear an echo? Sorry, yeah. So the wealth of information that's available out there is huge. Becomes all the more pertinent to see what you read, what you pay attention to, and how much.
Thank you. Anyone else?
Yes, me, Pratibha.
Yes, Kasim, tell me.
I see reading helps you to enhance your gaze and helps you perspectives, and one should use their gaze and think from different perspectives.
Can I?
Yes, please.
Yeah, I think the person who derives joy shall never get bored in life. He will have complete and bless the great minds. One-to-one. It is only through reading that we can know anyone, his mind, his thoughts, feelings, just as we come to know about Pratibha by meeting. Yeah, That's it.
And that again.
I think somebody else is speaking.
Yes, Pragya, 1 minute.
Yeah.
Pragya, go. Yeah, I mean, like some of the other speakers mentioned the joy of reading is actually the kind of thing, you know, that remains with you from the moment you pick up your first book to, you know, to forever, as long as you want it to, you know, keep you enthralled. There are now and then, you know, I'm part of a sort of like co-founder of a book club over here in Bombay, and so we have something like 16, 17 members. And every now and then, one or the other person shares a maybe those six of in a while, and I haven't read in all these years. The joy of reading is just the most amazing kind of joy that one can experience.
Thank you, Surya.
What I believe is just two things which creates this joy of reading books and all. First is part of the world we have been living in when we are reading these books. It is about creating your own perception about a thought, a book which you are reading. 10 people read so that's why I read, so that I create my own beautiful world around that book, and I forget everything that's happening around when I'm reading. I'm into my own world. That's what I feel gives the joy.
Yes, very true. And that is the reason when we read the book review of the book which we read, so many times it happens that you notice something new while even listening to book review. Okay, the theme which I selected today was, let me tell you my take on this, is April 23rd is William Shakespeare's birthday and also death anniversary. And it is celebrated as World Book Day. So I thought, why not to talk about joy of reading. And this is how I selected this theme. In fact, in India, the reading day is celebrated in the month of June and it has totally different story. So reading is an activity which we started in our childhood. Maybe the first activity which we were very much enthusiastic, we wanted to learn, we wanted to read, and it continued in different phases in a different way. For example, in the childhood, we loved it through the fairy tales. The adolescent age, we went through the science fiction, and afterwards, maybe later on in the office, some office reports and newsletters and all. And now, during the pandemic, so of course we read some books, but most of the time we were busy in reading the WhatsApp messages. So reading was always the main activity behind it. And joy of reading, I discovered when I had gone for the tour, traveling to Scotland and England heritage tour. Now this reading, I was an average reader. I always used to read the smallest book. The biggest book will always create a tension, stress. So I always used to prefer the smallest book. But when I went last vacation to Scotland and England Heritage Tour, and while the walking tour, when they took us to different authors' places and told us about the book. For example, in the Edinburgh, we went for this Harry Potter train. And literally the walking tour started from one sandwich place, sandwich stall, started from there where she used, where J.K. Rowling used to sit and write her stories. And later on, the guide took us to the graveyard where J.K. Rowling found her 700 plus names for the characters of her book. And my children and all other children and even grown-ups were so thrilled to see those names on those graveyard, what those stones. I was type of a mist. I missed that fun because I never read Harry Potter, thinking that that book is specially for children. And I enjoyed the tour. I enjoyed the information about the writing the book, about the author. And suddenly I decided, as soon as I came back to India, first I got all the 5 books and I started reading. So when I saw that amazement on that fans group or in that walking tour, I really felt that reading is the one thing which will always make you happy, which will take you to that place. And reading that too, reading with a purpose, which will always give you a new idea, new lead. And always read only one line. With this, I'd like to tell you, in Toastmasters, but all readers may not be Toastmasters. Toastmasters meeting has 3 different segments. For the benefit of guests, I would like to give here the brief description of each segment. The prepared speeches, that is, prepared speeches are all based on the pathways education. System, Toastmasters educational system pathway. Impromptu table topic session. The table topic session is all impromptu. Guests can participate and see, enjoy the topic. And third important segment is evaluation, where the senior Toastmasters and purpose speech. This takeaways for us. Every person will be having some or the other thing to learn in this meeting. The 3 it improves our brain connectivity. Second, it increases our vocabulary and comprehension. And third, it empowers you with other people to empathize. That is social bonding. And this, with these 3 benefits, similar to this, we have 3 pillars for this meeting, which are known as role players for this meeting. First is timer, our counter, and grammarian. May I invite Toastmaster Ashish as timer for this meeting. I will also request Toastmaster Ashish to tell us about the book which you like and brief description about it. Over to you, Toastmaster Ashish.
Good evening, everyone. Toastmaster of the day, Toastmasters, fellow Toastmasters, and guests. My duty is to time the prepared speeches, table topic speeches, and speech evaluations during this meeting. When a speaker reaches the minimum time allotted, I will display the green card. When the speaker reaches the midpoint of the time range allotted, I will display the yellow card. And when the speaker reaches the end of this speaking time, I will display the red card. The speaker has 30 seconds grace time before the green or after the red card is displayed to end the speech in order to qualify for the vote. I'll report qualifying times when called for. Just to answer Pratibha's question, what is the favorite book of mine? Actually, I'm not a book reader as such, but I have read once A Man's Search for Meaning. So that was a very good book. I don't recollect the name of the author, but it has led to, you know, why the men is, you know, working hard to achieve, you know, everything in life. That is for the purpose which you need to set. So to, you know, to have the search meaning that in, you know, small part of the book.
Thank you, Ashish.
Yeah, thank you.
I agree with you. This is one book which you will never keep it down until and unless you complete it. This is same thing happened with me also. Thank you, Ramanand, for giving us the writer's name also. And our next role player is our counter. Our counter, normally, it's a special role player in Toastmasters meeting. Here, the filler words which we use, which we may not notice, but they always notice. Let's welcome Toastmaster Tina for our counter. Welcome, Tina.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters and guests. The purpose of our counter is to listen to all speakers and note the number of below speaking errors for each participant. I will notice words or sounds used as crutch, such as ours, ums, filler words such as you know well, long pauses used as fillers, connective words such as and, so. Words may also be inappropriate interjections, example, and, but, or actually. Sounds may be ah, or er. As our counter, I will also note when a speaker repeats a word or phrase, example, I, so, so, this means, I will give a report when called upon at the end of the meeting. Thank you.
Thank you, Tina. I would also like to know about your favorite book.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Pratibha. My favorite book is a book it's called The Aristotle by Edith Hall. And the reason I like that book is because he always speaks about keeping the common good ahead before one's own self. And he calls this word called the eudaimonia, which means thinking and achieving the highest good in life. That's from my end. Thank you.
Thank you, Tina. I'm really enthusiastic to see that book.
Thank you. My pleasure.
Thank you. And our next role player is Grammarian. I welcome Toastmaster Chetan. And I also would like to know the book which you like most. Over to you, Toastmaster Chetan.
Am I audible and visible? Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. As a grammarian, Madam Toastmasters, fellow Toastmasters and guests, as a grammarian, it is my responsibility to pay close attention to all speakers, listening carefully to the language usage, and I'll take a note of any misuse of English language as well as any outstanding words, quotes, saying, thoughts. As a grammarian, it is also my duty to introduce the word of the day. But today's word of the day is decipher, meaning to change as a secret message from code into an ordinary language. Usage, we deciphered the hidden meaning to find out where we were supposed to meet. I encourage all the role players and speakers today to use the word of the day. Now to answer the about which book I like and why I would like to read. I like the book is Seven Habits of Highly Effective. I think highly effective people. I think most of us know about this book, and I'm assuming some of us also have read it. before Toastmasters, I think whatever I was, I think this book had a very big role to play in the whichever way I used to kind of think of, in terms of communication, in terms of dealing with people. And habits is a combination of skills, knowledge, and desires, and that forms our habit. That's what the book, the crux of the meaning of the book is. So I highly recommend everyone to read this book at least once in a while. And it is, it's been updated, and it's a very relevant to all of you. Thank you. Over to you, Toastmasters of the day.
Thank you, Chetan, for introducing my favorite book also. And now, it's our prepared speeches segment. Our first speaker is Toastmaster Pragya. She's attempting her evaluation and feedback session of level one and will be presenting a speech of 5 to 7 minutes. Her speech will be evaluated by Toastmaster Babu. May I welcome Toastmaster Babu for reading the purpose of the project. Over to you, Toastmaster Babu.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters, distinguished guests, and Toastmaster Pragya in particular. As the Toastmaster of the day has said, this is going to be a 5 to 7 minute speech on any genre of speaking, informational, humorous. And the main objective of this speech is for the speaker to apply the feedback that she will get from this speech to the speech that will follow in this level. So all the best to the speaker, Toastmaster Pragya, and we hope to have an inspirational and entertaining speech from you. Over to you. Over to Madam Toastmaster.
Thank you, Toastmaster Babu. Toastmaster Pragya, welcome to the virtual stage. Masked Toastmaster Pragya. Toastmaster Pragya, masked. Over to you.
Can I please see the timer screen? Can I please see the timer screen? I'm not able to see the timer screen.
Ashish. Toastmaster Ashish.
Oh.
Thank you. Now I can see. Imagine you look into the mirror, but you don't see yourself. You see a masked face looking back at you. Wouldn't you be scared? I was. Fellow Toastmasters and my dear masters, just few days before my 13th birthday, I was joyous beyond words. My father finally got a break after months. And as my birthday was approaching, I was super excited because I'm going to spend it with him. The joyous day, however, had a tragic end. While returning back from his work, a car accident took my father away from me forever, leaving me and my mother behind. After a few days, I could see my mother behaving her normal self, as if nothing had ever happened. I was furious. I asked her, how could you behave so normal, as if nothing has happened? Didn't you love him? My mother, with a pitiful look in her eyes and with pain, said, I loved him the most, but I can't show my pain to everybody. They won't understand it. Are you pretending then? But you always tell me to be myself. I don't understand this now. And I left the room. As days passed by, it was time for me to go back to my school. As I walked down the corridors of my school, I could see pitiful looks in everybody's eyes. Shh, she will not play. She just lost her father. Poor child, how will she cope up now? These words were even more painful putting a fake smile on my face to make everyone believe that I have adjusted and accepted the situation and I was coping well with it. But was I really fine inside? On the outside, things seemed good. On the inside, it was much more painful to hide my emotions. As time passed by, the need to put on these fake masks became more and more prominent. After wedding, there was no end to it. There were layers after layers which I kept putting to keep people around me happy, to fit into their view. At a particular instant, my husband came home, went to my in-laws room and just told me, "We are just discussing a family matter. I'll come out soon," and shut the door and went inside. This wasn't something new. This had happened before and lots of other things like this. But I always smiled my way through. Remember those times when you want to speak your heart out, your emotions out? But you had to stay quiet because it was for your loved ones. I was doing the same. But that half an hour, there was a storm in my head. I couldn't let it go again. Family matter? Who am I then? Am I not a part of their family? Why am I not a part of that discussion? It might seem to be a very small matter, but when things pile up, a time comes when you're full of everything. And today was a day for me. Today was that day for me. As my husband came out and casually asked me, "I hope I didn't keep you waiting for so long. It was just an important family matter for discussing." I decided to finally peel off my mask. It was tough, but I spoke finally. "Do you think I only felt left out right now? I'm deeply hurt. The family, to make mine, I did everything I could for 10 long years. I left my ambition. I left everything to fit into the molds of an ideal daughter-in-law, ideal wife, and an ideal mother. And you say it was just a family matter which I was not a part of?" As I was just speaking my heart out, I could see the mask slipping down my hands, falling on the floor and crashing into a million pieces just by venting out my emotions. The mask I have been wearing from the time my dad left us. I could feel the exhilarating feeling of happiness inside me because now I knew I don't need to pretend anymore. I can say what I want to say. I can be what I want to be. My fellow Toastmasters, today I urge you all, as you might have gotten very comfortable in the masks you have been wearing to keep your loved ones happy, sometimes to save your emotions, sometimes to save yourself. But today, don't be afraid. Sum up all your courage and speak your emotions out. The exhilarating feeling you will get will keep you happy. It's going to be tough. It's going to be painful initially. But I know you are stronger than that feeling and you can do it as I have done it. So then next time, when you see into that mirror, you don't see yourself masked. You see the real you smiling back at yourself. Believe in yourself. I am unmasked. Are you? Over to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you, Toastmaster Pragya.
Superb.
30 seconds for feedback. I request you all to send your feedback to Toastmaster Pragya. Thank you. Going forward, our next speaker is someone who is attempting his level 2 first speed of motivational strategies. Please welcome Toastmaster Vasudev. And this speech is evaluated by Toastmaster Nivedita, VP Education of Bombay Toastmasters Club. I invite Toastmaster Nivedita to read the purpose statement of this speech.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. Today, the speaker is attempting project 1 from second level of motivational strategies. The objective is to learn about different communication style and identify his own primary style of communication. And also the share the impact of his style on others. Timer, please note the time, 5 to 7 minutes. All the best. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nivedita. Toastmaster Vasudev, learning communication, Toastmaster Vasudev.
Good evening all. Am I audible and visible?
Yes, Vasudev.
Okay. Thank you, Madam Toastmaster of the day, and a very good evening to all the members and guests present. Communication is a lot like water. It is an essential part of the human life. And just like water, we have to focus on its importance in our daily functioning. Communication is important to express our thoughts and opinions and have meaningful discussions to resolve all our issues effectively. Just like water, communication also shares the attribute of adaptability. There is no right way of communicating in any situation. Hence, just like how water changes its form and shape depending on the terrain that it is in, we have to also adapt the way we express our thought based on the situation that we are in. Broadly speaking, there are 4 recognized styles of communication. The first is initiating. This style is characterized as an interactive style in which the focus is on sharing stories. Then there is the supportive style. In this style of communication, the speaker is calm and patient towards the listener and understands what the person in front is trying to convey. There is the direct style of communication. In this style of communication, the speaker is focused on delivering the message directly and in a very precise manner. And lastly, there is the analytical style of speaking, where the focus of the speaker is on facts and on asking questions when there are parts of the discussion that are not very clear. Having spoken about the theoretical side of communication, I would like to share a little bit about my identified style of communication. Well, it's more styles, as it turns out it's a blend of supportive and analytical communication. This is appropriate since I have had the maximum opportunity to exercise these 2 styles of communication. And let me share an example in this regard. This example is from my working profession. And while I had joined my work in early 2019, I was the newest member of my team. But over time, the dynamic of the team changed, like most things, and some senior members left and a lot of new members joined. This had a very interesting impact on my position in the team. Suddenly, from the newest member of the team, I became the senior most, one of the senior most member in the team. As a result of this change, there came an additional responsibility, the responsibility of mentoring and guiding the newer members of the team in understanding, in helping them rather understand the processes of the organization and clarifying their doubts. This role is very important as it helps the new members settle better into the team and hence has to be performed with care. A supportive style of communication since is characterized by patience, cooperation, and being sympathetic towards the person whom you are engaging with was very useful for me in this regard. The supportive communication style helped me clear various doubts and misconceptions of the team members and unknowingly helped me become the point of contact of my team. As time passed, members from not only my team, but also from various other teams started to approach me with their queries and questions. I certainly think that this wouldn't have been possible if I didn't have the traits of a supportive speaker. Further, in a work environment, it is often the case that precise and accurate information, which is to the point and does not beat around the proverbial bush, is also very critical. Since my style of communication also has a component of analytical style, it helped me send across my thoughts supported by factual data in a precise manner and address the comments and queries of my seniors also effectively. As a result of this, I was able to be part of various projects and pilot testing initiatives which are considered ad hoc or additional to your day-to-day job. Ultimately, the blend of supportive and analytical style of communication helped me build a strong rapport with my team members, with my counterparts, and with members outside of my team, which would have been difficult if I don't have the appropriate approach towards communication. Lastly, I would like to say that there is no one fit for all style of communication. Situations vary and communication also has to vary. It is key we recognize these styles and recognize the roles and adapt the way we use these techniques in our various communications. If the situation is of high importance and quick decision making is required, we should most certainly have the ability to change our way of thinking and discussing to the direct style of communication. While if the situation requires calmness, coolness, and patience to listen to the person in front of us and then express our thought, then we should be flexible enough to change to the supportive style of communication. If we are rigid in our way of communicating and not open to adapt, then we risk being misinterpreted by the many people that we meet. Hence, it is key that we learn to communicate so that we are able to deliver our message in the most effective and appropriate way. Thank you. And over to you, Madam Toastmaster of the Day.
You are mute, Kemudi.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vasudeva. 30 seconds for your feedback to the speaker. please send your feedback directly to Toastmaster Vasudev. This feedback always inspires the speaker and prepares him very well for his next speech. So whatever is your take, whatever is your opinion, please feel free and give the feedback. Coming back to our theme, that is reading. Now I would like to say about something about reading proficiency, which is very important and a fundamental skill for academic learning and success through learning. According to study done in US, the ability to read proficiently is significantly related to how much a person achieves in his professional or personal life. There are few strategies which we have to use while reading. Now, which are these strategies? These strategies will make our reading effective. We will remember whatever we read for a longer time and in an effective manner. The first one is choose your goal. You be a purposeful reader. What is the purpose of reading? We have to first decide that what is the purpose of reading, whether I'm reading for entertainment or gaining some information, or it is just to get more knowledge about any other topic. So the purpose will always strategize. It will always make the effective use of reading. The second strategy is visualizing. Visualization requires the reader to construct an image of what is read. This is very important. The image is stored in your reader's memory as a representation of reader's interpretation of the text, and it remains there for a longer time. You may be remembering whatever we learned in our school days, we still remember. It's only because of this visualization. The third strategy, which is very important, is making connections. Making connections is also used by reading process. Making connections, the learner can activate connection with whatever knowledge he already had and whatever he is reading. So he puts more to his prior knowledge and connect the idea with the whatever current knowledge level, and thus his experience and exploration gets beliefs also gets changed, transformed. So making connection is very important. And finally, it is summarizing. Summarizing is whatever you have read, it's important to condense it, to comprehend it in your own words and write it somewhere. Make it in your words, connect it to your experience. And then you will see that this is what you will organize your ideas very effectively. And whatever you read, you will always remember. And this is why the book reviews are very popular, because big book reviews always gives whoever the reviewer's point of view in while summarizing. And these four strategies will always help you making your reading habit effective. Coming to the next project, our next speaker is Toastmaster Sudha. Toastmaster Sudha is attempting her level 4 project from effective coaching path. I would like to request the evaluator, Toastmaster Ramanan, to tell us briefly about the purpose of the speech objective and also your favorite book which you enjoyed most in few days. Over to you, Toastmaster Ramanan.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Pratibha. The purpose of this project that our speaker Toastmaster Sudha is attempting is for the member to learn about practice facilitating a question and answer session. The purpose of this speech is for the member to practice delivering an informative speech and running a well-organized question and answer session. The member is responsible for managing time, so there is adequate opportunity for both. The time limit is 15 to 20 minutes. So timer, please note, green at 15, at 17 and a half, the yellow, and red at 20. I wish our speaker all the best. Coming to my favorite book, I generally tend to read a lot of self-help, so Atomic Habits, and the tagline or the slogan for that book is somewhere around tiny tiny little efforts lead to remarkable changes. So that is one book that has definitely helped me a lot in overcoming my bad habits and developing or cultivating new ones, good ones. Back to you, Toastmaster Pratibha.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ramanan. Atomic Habits is a very famous book. And I think if you want to read something on habit, you want to start some book, start with Atomic Habits, and you will get many more ideas on habit and how the habit is formed. Toastmaster Sudha. I welcome Toastmaster Sudha. We are the world. We are the world. Toastmaster Sudha.
Time. Before I start timer, can I see your card, please? Yeah, this is a better position. I hope you won't change your position. You will be here, right? Otherwise, I have to search for you. This is okay. Thank you.
A time when we heed a certain call, when the world must come together as one. There are people dying. Oh, when it's time to lend a hand to life, the greatest gift of all. We can't go on pretending day by day that someone somewhere will soon make a change. We all a part of God's great big family, and the truth, you know, love is all we need.
Masters and distinguished guests. I think we all must have tapped our feet to such a beautiful song, seeing all the music maestros giving us a message which probably we have forgotten and need to be actually reminded of. My message to you today in this ugly dooming phase of pandemic is that we all are living in this world with a common goal and a common objective, and we kind of have forgotten this. My project here is to just reiterate this fact a little bit more stronger into your minds, and I make this attempt to revisit the thoughts which we have been used to listening for a very long time but need a reminder to. So what am I actually talking about? We are talking about sustainability development goals. Yeah. Now, what are sustainability development goals, you might ask? I'm a banker, and I think when I talk about it as a banking terminology, there are a lot of funds which are available in the market where people say that you can actually be a part of investing if you make it like an impact investing and be a part of a process where you are contributing to the world as well. Friends, just before I go further, have you been, can you see what I'm showing? Sorry. I need to be able to share the screen. Sorry, I think I've been.
Yeah, Sudha, just a second. Yeah, you can do it now.
Okay. So what are we talking about here? This is basically climate action, clean energy, circular economy, better health, reduced inequalities, life on land and underwater. Now, these are all headings. But let me tell you, the message is that we have a sustainability goal, unfortunately, which we've forgotten, and we need to probably steer ourselves to think about it, even in spite of us going through bigger problems in life. 2021 saw a kind of a global recovery, actually, from the emerging markets. If you really see the stock markets, it had done very well in the initial first three quarters of the year. And why you would think? Because people were wanting to start getting back to work and drive the global GDP growth. But there has been a focus on climate change. There have been a lot of bushfires in California, Australia. And even amidst the pandemic, we kept on hearing about this. And I don't know whether we turned our heads away to this. There have been renewed pledges, the Paris Accord, after Biden has come forth again, which Trump didn't support a lot, has again been in the center stage. The circular economy, now why circular economy? The importance of a reduce, reuse, and recycle philosophy has been reinstilled into every country today. We all have our trash cans being separated into dry waste and wet waste. At least if it's not come to our society, it's somewhere around the corner and it will knock your door very soon. The consciousness has started. Better health, reduced inequalities. The pandemic has again shown us that we are absolutely, the disparity between the rich and the poor is so high that people with basic, people who cannot afford basic health care, and the state of affairs is so bad, not only in our developing country, even in a developed country. Countries like Europe and America were actually put to test when the pandemic hit them, and the second and the third mutant was really taking the life out of so many citizens. Life on land and underwater, why is this important? I think we all have again become very conscious of recycling, plastic. We don't get plastic bags anymore. There is a lot of importance given to recyclable, biodegradable cosmetics, even the things that we use on a regular basis. So what is the sustainability outlook for 2021? We all have seen that because of pandemic, there has been a lot of uncertainty and a lot of paradigms have shifted for economies and for industries. There has been a bigger importance for affording, for providing quality healthcare, and the governments are really trying their best to achieve this goal. The policymakers led by EU and US have been negotiating different green alternative strategies. And actually, you won't believe it, there has been an amount of $350 billion which have been put into the investment market so that everybody can participate in this particular drive. You invest in stock markets, but you invest in a sensible and a meaningful manner so that the world that you live in becomes a better place. That is what is the message here. Diversity and inclusion will continue to be the focus, as they say, for and reduce economic inequalities in the world. Now, what is my topic or what is my message here? In 2015, around 25th to the 27th September, New York headquarters, New York UN headquarters, 193 countries met. And actually, that was the 70th anniversary of United Nations. And what do they discuss then? Mm-hmm. They discuss the fact that we have to transform the world by 2030, the agenda for sustainable development. Actually, there was a lot of brainstorming which happened. India was a part of it. Of course, the G7, G10 nations were also there. But I think the most important message was we don't have time anymore. We all have to be in this together. And they drafted 17 sustainable development goals. So what is it? It's about 5 P's. It's about the people, it's about planet, it's about partnership, peace, and prosperity. So people, yes, they constitute a very important aspect where you end poverty, hunger, in all forms and ensure dignity and equality. I'm not saying we have a complete solution, but the fact that we are aware and mindful about it, we are driving towards the goal, is a very important achievement. Prosperity, ensure prosperous and fulfilling lives in harmony with nature, not forgetting that we are destroying nature every day by the products that we use, by the treatment that we give to nature, or, you know, we can avoid all that, we should avoid it. Protect our planet's natural resources. And how can this be achieved? By partnership between the countries. Countries are partnering with each other. There is a lot of things which are happening behind the scenes, which I think we all need to give attention to, because I think most of us are inundated with WhatsApp universities providing a lot of information to us. But there is also some good news I think we need to feel good about. The three dimensions of sustainable development is economic growth, social inclusion, and environmental protection. These are very important aspects, three dimensions of the sustainable development. It is universal, it's transformative, it is indivisible. So now there is no time left. We have to implement it. So basically, what are the 17 goals we are talking about? These are the goals, friends. No poverty, zero hunger, good health, well-being, quality education, gender equality, clean water and sanitation, affordable and clean energy, decent work and economic growth, industry, innovation and infrastructure, reduced inequalities, sustainable cities and communities, responsible consumption and production, climate action, life below water, life on land, peace, justice, and strong institutions, partnerships for the goal. Basically, every country had this as a goal, and everybody had to come out with a plan as to how they're going to be achieving this. So a lot has been said and written about. I'll just try to bring you to the amount of work which has gone into it. So if you look at goal one, there have been 7 targets. There have been events which have been organized, publications. Similarly, in all these goals, there are achievements and what they really need to do so far. So let's just take one goal, for example. So if you're looking at this, so they know that COVID is a very important aspect, which has probably made the progress a little back. But I think the research is still continuing. They are still trying to realign the figures with the COVID pandemic affecting these objectives and goals. So there are some improvements. There are some problems which have happened because of COVID, but I think the effort is still on. Women bear additional household burdens during the pandemic. Now that's something we couldn't have avoided. Therefore, we are talking about gender equality. How can that stop if the woman cannot even leave the house because she has to be staying at home and burdening it? So lockdowns are increasing the risk of violence against women and girls. That's another very sad aspect of COVID, which has changed these goals a little bit. coming. Oops. Can you guys see what I'm showing clearly? So this is the first goal, and the first goal actually talks about how we can reduce poverty. Now, you might think that the government, I think we are inundated with so much information, and I'm definitely not a Modi supporter here at all. Please don't get me wrong if any kind of assumptions are made here. But I think we all need to look at the good things which are happening also. So there have been about 3 or 4 schemes which have been introduced by the government, which is actually towards rural employment guaranteeing scheme. There is also Mahaniti Ayog, which is another one which the government has probably come put it into picture, as well as the National Social Assistance Program. These are all programs which are built to get an equalization of wealth accumulation or wealth dispersion in some manner or the other. The other one is goal 2, good health and well-being. That's a very important aspect for all of us to feel comfortable staying in our own country. Am I right? So there is a big drive in the country on nutrition. I've seen it. I've come back to the country after about almost 20, 22 years. And I can see people are so conscious about nutrition. Everyone is talking about nutrition. There are nutrition camps, there are dietitians, there are nutrition. Not one single person is not aware of it. And maybe even the second or the third person is already employing these services for their well-being and good health. That's a very good thing. What about people who don't have the access to all these amenities? The government has also introduced certain schemes called the Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana, National Mission on Sustainable Agriculture. So don't forget, we all know that agriculture is a big part of our income. And if you're going to ignore it just because we are living in metros, it's not going to be a good thing for all of us. We get our food only if the farmers are satisfied. And yes, there have been problems. There are still agitations. People are not resolving the issues. People are still, politics gets into it. Red tapism gets into it. But we still have to be conscientious of the fact that we have to move this ahead. There are a lot of negative elements, but we have to continue our search for this. There are some good websites and good things which are done by these websites, which I want to introduce you guys on. There are book clubs, like somebody mentioned about book clubs. There are a lot of books and a lot of information on climate action. On each goal, there are a lot of book clubs which are produced. There are blogs which are written, even for children to be a part of the whole journey. There are books which are written and are recommended by these websites so that people can continuously be aware of it. Our India is also contributing a lot in this journey. And you all know about a few things. And this is what 8-year-old Lissy Priya, she has actually demanded to Narendra Modi to take some action on climate. There was a message underneath, don't call her the Greta of India. She is an Indian per se with her own objective. The other thing, cleanup removes of around 10,000 kilograms of waste from the river Ganga has happened. There is also Earth Day. EDN coordinator brings solar to Himalayan monastery. These were the women trekkers who bought solar lighting to a 600-year-old monastery in northern India. Conservation and restoration. Indian village plants 111 trees when a girl is born. I mean, these are things which have to be commended and applauded. And I think it was important for all of us to think about this is toxic air pollution suffocates New Delhi. This is a sad part, yes. So what my message to you, everybody, is that we all need to take a conscientious role into this journey. And there are a lot of initiatives which people have started. And if you can contribute in any way, either by being volunteers for these initiatives or maybe in by finance or any of those kind of initiatives, it will be a great help to the cause. And we don't know, 2030 is far away. We might be one of the champions in this particular journey. UN is ready to subsidize a lot of these initiatives taken by the country. So I think we as citizens also need to do our little bit in trying to achieve these goals. I would probably send you the link on the chat or on the group for you all to be able to read and understand a little bit more about it and see how you can contribute. But in the meanwhile, I'm open to taking any questions on this, and I will probably leave the floor open to questions now. Thank you.
Sudha, I have a question. Thanks for this, the knowledge that you imparted. This is, you know, something different, and we all talk about the environment, we all talk about renewable, etc. What I wanted to understand is, what is one small thing that each one of us can do beginning now, which will probably help us move towards sustainability?
Well, I think there are a lot of objectives, a lot of things that each one of us can do. I think probably stop using buses and rickshaws and cars, and please don't take out a car just for one person. That is something absolutely should be kicked out of the environment. I mean, you cannot afford it anymore. Look at the traffic which happens. Look at the petrol emission which happens. What about water? Water is another thing. What about people being conscious about putting off lights, air conditions, fans, whenever? I've seen, even when you go out of the office, there are so many offices which are not really following that. Till the last doorman comes and puts it off, it's never put off. So there are a few things we all can do. And I think we all are aware of it, but sometimes we forget it because we think it's not our responsibility. It's okay, somebody else will look into it. But I think it's time that phase is over, according to me. I consider myself to be a champion for this. I try my best in every day. What is it that I can do? There are lots of things which we can do, Manish. I mean, if you go to these websites, there are things that we can contribute in our own way on a daily basis. And there are a lot of groups which are there, which I can't cover in this particular forum. But yes, I'm glad that you asked that question. We can do a lot of things. I can provide more information on this if required.
Thank you. Please share that. And as a cyclist, yes, I would always be happy if people take the cycling.
Yes, you're already doing that. Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. Look at countries like Sweden and Norway. They don't even take out the cars. They are always on cycle. And there was another interesting insight which I read somewhere that, you know, when there is a concert in a particular place, and I think it was in UK or something, you'd always see the cars are parked a little far away from the venue. People want to walk. And maybe it's not known for people like us, such a behavior. Because you would always see Indians parking the closest to the venue. Yeah. And they will never want to leave that place for anything. Insensible, according to me.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I have something to ask. Since time immemorial, we have been talking about sustainable development goals at the macro level, with the world at large. But I think this pandemic has exposed so much of fissures in the thinking, where today rich countries are cornering vaccines, depriving probably the third world countries, when ideally, if you say that there should be equitable distribution, that doesn't seem to be happening. And the worst affected seems to be the third world countries, as much as they have also been affected by policies relating to nutrition, health, and all that. So I don't know how far really these development goals and the policies have been really understood or maybe understood but implemented by the various powers to be, the rich countries around the world. I don't know how effective it has been.
Absolutely. I agree with you. Thank you, Babu. It's a very important and pertinent question. So when we work on a lot of good things, we wonder, when these kind of situations happen, we wonder, like, what is this? Where is all this going? 100% true. My only take on this is that we don't have a choice. The big might do something to oppress the poorer countries. They have been doing it for a long time. But I think pandemic has changed a lot of things for the good and for the bad. I think it regularized the whole world in some manner. It kind of normalized the whole world in some manner, because if they were rich, they were still not being able to handle the pandemic the way we also could have handled. Though we were ahead of the game in some way, we were not probably disciplined, but the richer countries are going through the same problem. So that's the normalizing which has happened because of the pandemic. But yes, they have a clout. Yes, they have a way to get to the resources. And I think it's the politicians, and we always have learned that we need to have mediators, and that's how probably human beings are trained to. Maybe I think once dust settles down, all these things will be questioned, and all these things will be, because now it's the matter of death. So I think normalcy cannot work, I guess. That's my take on that. Thank you. Any more questions? I hope you found
our time limit is over.
Okay.
So questions, you can take it on chat if anyone has have, and offline you can answer.
Okay. Thank you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Sudha. And now, I would like to invite timer of the day for the timing report of prepared speeches. Over to you, Toastmaster Ashish.
Thanks, Toastmaster Pratibha. Vasudev, Pastor Vasudev has been 7.21 minutes. Toastmaster Pragya has taken 6.95 minutes, and Toastmaster Sudha has taken 25.20 minutes. So other than Toastmaster Sudha, Toastmaster Pragya and Vasudev are only eligible for voting.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ashish.
I just want to highlight, as there are only two speakers who are qualified.
That's fine, Nivedita.
Okay.
Now it's time to our next segment, that is table topics. This segment will be headed by someone who is division level champion in table topics, who loves to help others, who is always ready to take any role or any speeches in Toastmasters community. And please welcome Toastmaster Ankit as Table Topic Master. Table Topic Master, stage is all yours.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Pratibha, for the opportunity and the glad introduction.
I will request Toastmaster Ankit to please adjust the speakers as per the time available.
Sure.
Okay, thank you.
So, everyone's life story particularly revolves around the books he or she has read from childhood. I am lucky enough to right now have all the three books available with me. Like all our childhood began with something like this, wherein we could draw, read, and learn something from it. As we grew up, we thought that there should be something enriching in our lives we learn something from it and apply something practical out of it. So you jump to these books. But books and magazines like this still give me sleepless nights. Good evening, readers and speakers, to another evening of Table Topics. And as they could say, strange things are happening around. There is pandemic all over the country, except four states and one union territory. When it comes to cricket, Mumbai Indians is losing the match and Royal Challengers Bangalore is winning all them. But how can District 98 keep itself out of the competition? Strange things are happening here as well. Clubs are being chartered few hours before the contest. And guess what? The contestants can even win and go up to the division level. For all those confused faces, I believe that Toastmaster Sudha and Toastmaster Babu get the joke right. So, let me quickly begin with the purpose of this table topic session. The purpose of table topic session is to improve your impromptu speaking skills. So, the agenda of this session is simple. You nominate yourself, you will be invited, and then you will be given a topic to speak on 1 to 2 minutes. And if your topic is enjoyed by everyone, you will be getting votes on the basis of which you will be chosen as the best table topic speaker. Now, there's a catch in it. You need to finish it within your time limit. So to explain the time limit, let me please invite on stage the timer for the evening, Toastmaster Ashish.
Dear Toastmasters and fellow Toastmasters and guests, for table topic sessions, we have 1 to 2 minutes. So when a speaker reaches the minimum time allotted, that is one, will display a green card. When the speaker reaches 1.3 minutes, will display a yellow card. And when it reaches 2 minutes, will display a red card. Over to you, Toastmaster Ankit.
Thank you for making a note of that, Toastmaster Ashish. And yes, to all those speakers and those participants, let me please mention you one thing, that there'll be 30 seconds of grace time. So do not see red and go panic at all. You will be still given 30 seconds to sum it up. So, and also remember to use the word of the day, because the R counter and the grammarian will also be doing their job silently and picking out all your mistakes and the good use, a good word spoken. So, as we say that there are 7 colors in the rainbow, so we can also expect 7 colors of topics today. So, let me immediately invite a Toastmaster for the first topic, so that the first timer guest who have not yet experienced what a table topic session is might understand that how it goes around. So can we have our first nomination for the evening, please? Come on, everyone, I'm waiting for my first speaker. Please put up your, okay, I have multiple requests right now, and I see Toastmaster Sunil. Toastmaster Sunil, could you please be, could he be highlighted right now? Uh, I can see three hands right now. Ah, Toastmaster Sunil, there you are.
Yeah.
So yes. Can you please choose any one color of the rainbow?
Blue.
Okay. So, Toastmaster Sunil, here is your topic. A fictional character from a book I would love to meet. A fictional character from a book I would love to meet, Toastmaster Sunil.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ankit, and good evening to everyone. It's taken me some time to volunteer for a table topic. It's sort of uncharted territory for me. And then at the start of the meeting, I heard the grammarian and the counter giving a long list of do's and don'ts. And I was wondering whether I should go. To add to it, there was this word decipher, which I'm still trying to decipher as to how to use it. But nevertheless, talking about books and the topic here, my relationship with books has by and large been like old classmates. While we are fond of each other, but we have not kept in touch too much. And I would like to confess that I'm not too much of an avid reader. I have not been. More or less, my choice of books has been decided by the number of pages in it. So the lesser, the better. Having said that, in terms of the kind of books that I've read and I've been reading, started off reading fiction. That was in my childhood, and post that academics hit you. And so it was more accountancy and so on, right? And then by the time you join job life, you try to get touch with current affairs, because every time you get into something, somebody suggests that current affairs is very important, and so it is more news. Starting from Shekhar Gupta to whosoever. So that's what it has been. But having said that, in terms of what are the kind of books which I've really enjoyed in my life, I have generally enjoyed the magnum opus kind of books. So if I'm to say books like maybe Masters of the Game, or something like The Class by Eric Segal. So in terms of, if you really are to ask me what are the characters that I would probably want to sort of, get closer to or want to understand more, would probably be those students from the class of Harvard, in The Class, where they started off being mere students, and then each one of them went on to achieve great things in life. So maybe, yes, that would probably be my desire. Thank you very much. Let's stop here.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sunil, for that lovely insight. And yes, we have loads of hands coming up. I can see in my chat box. And since we have so many lovely guests, sorry, dear Toastmasters, but this evening should be reserved for our guests. So the next one on my list is Mr. Ronak Banka. Ronak, can we please have your video spotlighted?
Hi. Hello.
Hi, Ronak.
Hi. I haven't attended any of the Toastmaster session only. So this is the first thing, session only of my life.
Okay. I hope you'll enjoy participating in this. So quickly, sure. Choose any of the colors from your seven rainbows. Let me tell you, blue has been taken.
Red.
Okay. So Ronak, your topic is my favorite genre of books. My favorite genre of books, Ronak.
Okay, hi. So my favorite genre of book is the self-help book, because I really love decipher the normal language into the self-help books, like the way they teach, the way the method, like we have a monk who sold his Ferrari. That book, the monk was such a character that he really made us enjoyed the reading the books, the seven processes which he said. As in the Toastmaster session only, just today only, someone mentioned about the Atomic Habits. That book is also too good. So my favorite genre is the self-help books, because I have tons of self-help books in my home library, basically. So they help a lot for us. Like, it helps for personal branding. They help you in each and every way. And hence, I love self-help books. Thank you, Angit.
Thank you so much, Ronak, for that lovely insight. And trust me, Monk Who Sold His Ferrari was the first ever book that I read, because it was gifted to me by a dear friend. And trust me, all the tips and all the guides, all the guidelines are so beautiful in this. Yeah. Thank you for that.
Yeah.
And quickly moving on to our next participant, that is guest Manoj Singh. He has raised his hand. So yes, Manoj Singh, could we please put the spotlight on him? Manoj? Quickly select one color of the web gear. Blue and red have been taken.
Okay. I select orange.
Okay.
Orange.
So, interesting one. Manoj, are romantic novels realistic? Are romantic novels realistic, Manoj?
I haven't this is the topic, but I don't think romantic novels are realistic. I personally means I haven't read any. I go to that extent, but yeah, but the romance, I personally believe that romantic novels means taking imagination to means higher level, that may be possible, but are they realistic? Are they really develop a relation, a level of interaction, a realistic level of connect? I personally doubt it. So I personally keep myself away. I personally believe more on a human connect, a one-to-one connect, and discovering each other. Directly asking the question from a real guy. That I believe more of a real thing, making things more clear and better. Personally, my view, because I haven't read many, but I personally think that what could can be is that had they been realistic, they get to a real story among two persons, then I would personally take it. But if it is imagination and it may be a lot of joy to oneself, imagining good things, what one's like, that would be okay. So far, if it is a purely entertainment point of view, otherwise I think that one-to-one personal connect has an altogether different feeling. So I personally not a big fan of a romantic, and I think they are not close to reality. Back to the Toastmaster.
Thank you, Manoj, for your views on this. And personally, I put this topic for someone who could change my belief into the otherwise, that they are indeed realistic, but in turn, you have made my belief more strong that they are not realistic. So thank you for your insight. And yes, we have Pragya. keeping a contrast opinion that yes, they are, but not complete. So yes, Pragya, 50% you are on our side. So quickly moving on to our next speaker for the evening, and who has already delivered an icebreaker, I must say. It is Shrijoy. Could we please put the spotlight on Shrijoy?
Hi.
Hello, Shrijoy. So you are quite aware of how it's been going. So yes, quickly select one color.
Green.
Okay. Shrijoy, a movie or a web series where you felt the original novel was much better. A movie or a web series where you felt the original novel was much better. Shrijoy.
I think almost all movies or web series fall in that category where the actual book and the actual story is far better, because more often than not, the scope and span of a web series or a movie is limited, and you can only show so much in maybe an hour and a half, 2 hours, 16 episodes, 21 episodes, or what have you. You can only pick and choose certain aspects of certain books, of the book, of the story, and represent that on the screen. While you did ask me this question to tell you of one book that I felt was better than the web series or the film, I would have to say the one book or the one web series that I thought came very close to capturing almost entirely what was written in the book was Life of Pi. However, even though it came so close to representing exactly what was mentioned in the book, in its endeavor to do so, it completely lacked soul. If you read Jan Martel's Life of Pi, and of course some of his other books also, you really realize what he's talking about in terms, when he talks about faith, what he talks about what he's trying to convey, that representation on celluloid was very good. It was spectacular. It was brilliant. But it ended up, lacking soul. So I, in my opinion, almost all books are better than their films or web series. Over to you, Ankit. Thank you very much.
And that are true signs of a book lover. And trust me, you see any book lover in this world, he or she will always say that the book was 1,000 times better. Whether it's the Game of Thrones series or any other, but on similar lines of Life of Pi, I believe that one such novel and one such movie which I felt that was at par was To Kill a Mockingbird. So all those people who are left with no work and are finding that which book to read, trust me, To Kill a Mockingbird is the perfect choice for you. You can watch it online or you can read it. Lucky if you can lay your hands on a paperback copy.
Can I just say something? I think the reason for that was Gregory Peck. Nobody could have done Atticus Finch the way he performed Atticus Finch.
Precisely. You stole the words from my face. Although, yes, we have one final topic, because I have been getting pinched to wrap it up. I'm extremely sorry that we are paucity of time, but yes, we can definitely come back with better topics. One last topic, and that is Varun Sharma. Varun Sharma, can we please have you spotlighted?
Yeah, hi. Good evening, Ankit.
Hello, good evening, Varun. So quickly, please select one color. Let me tell which all are available for you. It's violet, indigo, yellow.
I'll choose yellow.
Okay. Varun,
yeah.
A book I love to read multiple times and still not get bored. a book I love to read multiple times and still not get bored, Varun.
Yeah, first of all, Ankit, I just want to clarify that I'm a fan of fiction over here. Everyone was talking about self-help and guides, etc. But still, I'm a fiction guy all in all. And one book that I like to tell you about is Shantaram by Gregory David Roberts. I came to know it about when I came to stay in Mumbai. So my seniors told me, I used to live in Colaba only. So they told me that since you live here, that you must read that book. And ever since that I got my hands on that book, I must say that every time I pick it up, it tells me something about Mumbai that in our daily course of life, we do not see it about. So just and that philosophical remnants in that book is there are so many things about life that book teaches you about different aspects. And to sum it up, I say that if you are staying in Mumbai, you call yourself or you are happy to say that you are a Mumbaikar, I must say that you should go and read it once. That would be all. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Varun, for adding another book to our suggestion. So I believe that all our Toastmasters and guests who have joined us for the evening, you cannot complain that I do not have anything to read or watch anything in the lockdown, whether it gets extended to another week or another month. God forbid it does not. No one genuinely wants a lockdown. So that was all from this lovely session. It was an amazing, amazing session. And trust me, after so many weeks, so many meetings, it has been to this club's fortune that there has been only one Toastmaster speaker and the rest all our guests. So please put up a huge round of applause for yourself for coming up, nominating yourself and taking up that brave chance of being a table topic speaker. That's all from my end. And if you promise me to join the meet next week as well, trust me, I would love to be the table topic master once again and come up with such interesting topics. That was all from my side. This was the table topic master, Ankit Satanikar, and over to you, Toastmaster Ashish, first to let us the timing guideline. The timer report.
Yeah, thanks, Toastmaster Ankit. Toastmaster Sunil has taken 3.1 minutes. Guest Ronak has taken 1.15 minutes. Guest Manoj has taken 2.01 minutes. Guest Srijoy has taken 2.15 minutes. Guest Varun has taken 1.07 minutes. So other than Toastmaster Sunil, all the guests are eligible for voting.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Ashish. So it's evident that the best table topic speaker for the evening will definitely go to a guest. And thank you so much, Toastmaster Ashish, for the timing report. And I'll quickly hand it over to the Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Pratibha. Over to you.
Thank you, Ankit, for such an interesting session. All the book lovers who may label them as introvert, but still today they talked about the books and everything. And at the same time, we got so many new books suggestions. I'm sure we all are going to grab those copies. Now it's time for evaluation. Evaluation segment is very important segment in Toastmasters meeting. And this session, this segment is headed by our ex-president and who wears multi hats in Toastmasters community and also outside community, a very good singer of cyclist, yoga enthusiast and whatnot. Please welcome Toastmaster Manish, and I will request Toastmaster Manish to tell us about the book which you enjoyed the most. Over to you, Toastmaster Manish.
Thank you, Toastmaster Pratibha. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Jeanette Winterson said, books and doors are the same thing. You open them and you go to another world. So honestly, I mean, today's session has been enthralling in that respect for, you know, the different kinds of books that I got to know. Honestly, Man's Search for Meaning was a book that I have been wanting to read, but when it was recommended by multiple people, I just went to Amazon and added it to the cart. If I talk about my favorite book, which I have read umpteen times, I'm a fiction lover, of course. So I have loved Not a Penny More, Not a Penny Less by Jeffrey Archer. I can read it umpteen times and not get bored. It is such a delightful book, and I have always enjoyed reading that. Apart from that, I'm a big fan of John Grisham. So his books are phenomenal. Of course, the movies don't match up anywhere to where the books are. Ankit, just for your reference, another person is Robert Ludlum. His Bourne Identity, his entire Bourne series cannot be translated to movies ever. My daughter is a big fan of Harry Potter, but I have failed to decipher any joy in reading Harry Potter. Okay, I don't understand because I watched one movie in which Harry Potter is going on a broom and running up and down or whatever he was doing. And I said, what is this? This is such a stupid thing. And I just switched off. Ever since then, I have not bothered even to go anywhere near Harry Potter. I always tell my daughter that your books are so heavy, you could probably do weightlifting with them. So anyway, that apart, let's get on with the evaluation section, which is considered the most important section of the meeting. So I have my team of evaluators and team role players. So I would first like to start with the timer who's going to give us the timing guidelines for the evaluation. So may I request Toastmaster Ashish to give us the timing guidelines for the evaluators, please.
Thanks, Toastmaster Manish. For a timer of evaluation, we have, when a speaker, we have 3 minutes. When a speaker reaches some time allotted, that is about 2 minutes, we'll display a green card. When a speaker reaches 2.3 minutes, we'll display a yellow card. And when a speaker reaches 3 minutes, will display a red card. The speaker has 30 seconds grace time before green or after the red card is to end the speech in order to qualify for the vote. I'll report the qualifying times when called for. Over to you, Toastmaster Manish.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ashish. So we'll start with the evaluation of the speech projects, which we have our evaluators. So the first speech by Toastmaster Pragya, the project, is being evaluated by Toastmaster Babu. May I request Toastmaster Babu to present his evaluation for the speech project, please?
Thank you, Mr. General Evaluator, fellow Toastmasters, distinguished guests, and speaker Toastmaster Pragya. You have made my life very difficult, and that is my way of complimenting you for that wonderful speech. They say well begun is half done. And Toastmaster Pragya, you got us all hooked right from the start when you unraveled the mystery of the title Masked with your very opening lines. Imagine when you look at yourself in the mirror, but you are not able to see yourself. That's because you're wearing a mask. And you went on to elaborate this idea through various personal incidents. The first one, indeed, a very touching one, when on your 13th birthday, you lost your father, but you had to put on a mask in school to show that life was very normal for you. You brought out excellent characterization in your speech, especially the one dialogue that you had with your mother, who was putting on a brave face in spite of the incident that had happened. And much contrary to the advice that she normally would give you to always be yourself. your emotions showed right through this, the pain that you felt when you had to put on this mask all the time. And perhaps the last straw on the camel's back was when you were left out of the family's discussion, as if you were not part of the family itself, and you were expected all the same to wear the mask of a daughter-in-law, an ideal mask of a daughter-in-law, a wife, and the mother. And then the pain came out when you said, that was enough. I had to unmask myself. And you went ahead with a message where you said, you told the audience that unmask yourself, don't be afraid. Summon your courage and speak your emotions out. In fact, it was a highly impactful speech with a call to action as well at the end. And I think the essence of your speech was brought out by two main factors. One was the emotions that you expressed right through, and for which you used your voice and body language to the maximum effect. I like that very much. And the second was the smile that you had right through. That really made us all feel so good to listen to your speech, which otherwise was very impactful. I was trying to figure out what I could do to give you a few suggestions for enhancing the speech. Let me see where I have written that. Okay. I thought, since you used a prop, which was a very good idea, but perhaps you could have used the prop to greater effect when you could have started the speech, probably with the mask itself, and said those opening lines as to say that this is what you see in the mirror. You don't see your real self. And that would have been a much more powerful opening, perhaps, for you to try out. Your speech was peppered with personal anecdotes, as it should be. But I thought the entire speech revolved around the incidents in your life to justify why one should remain unmasked. Now, the question that I got in my mind was, what happens in a professional setup? Like sometimes they say, you have to fake it to make it. So do we always remain unmasked, even in a professional setup? So perhaps you could have brought in a second dimension to your speech as to whether unmasking or masking is good in all circumstances. And the one small little point that I would like to say is that when you were talking of the very touching incident about your father, perhaps what you could have done is, in such a very touching speech, you could have lowered your voice a little, maybe remained silent, allowed the solemnity of the occasion to sink in with the audience. And that could have also brought in an extra effect. But I think overall, you ticked almost all the right boxes. Your construction was good, transition was good, pauses were good. You had excellent voice modulation, body language, and of course, that very effacing smile. So I would say that overall, it was a fantastic speech, and I wish you all the best. Over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Babu. The second speech project by Toastmaster Vasudev is being evaluated by Nivedita. May I request Nivedita to present her report?
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. The art of the communication is the language of leadership, is what we all Toastmasters believe. And today, Toastmaster Vasudeva shared exactly the same with us. Toastmaster Vasudeva, your start has hooked me, as you started by saying communication is like a water. And I just try to see what comes next. And then the way you beautifully compared communication with water, right from the its essential nature to how it can mold into a different form, and then from there you shifted to the communication style very beautiful. So the way you, the transitions are made, definitely they are very good transitions. And then as a part of the objective, you really shifted easily to your own experiences, where you have beautifully said how you were on the learning curve and the different communication styles helped you to excel better, to transform yourself from a new joinee to maybe an experienced professional and be a mentor at the same time, and it helped you to handle multiple roles. So both went hand in hand and made you the way you are, a very good professional you are. So the how to make your speeches transform as fast as the way you transform yourself, how you will make those better. Vasudeva, I would love to see and hear more about your style and impact through your speech, actually. The way you said you have multiple communication styles, at least we would have liked to know the way you have interacted with your colleagues or interacted with your seniors or maybe at your personal front, so that we would come to know your styles easily. I miss that. And then you could have take the help of your vocal variety or some hand gestures, expressions, because when you say you have that anxiety of talking, telling everything, when it comes everything to you and you have a different role altogether, but and then the way you become a confident professional. So that transition you could have shown with your different expression, and that could have added much to your speech. So all in all, one more thing is your vocal variety, which you can add and which will could have support your styles where you are saying anxiety or the way you have more confident possibility. Thanks. So all in all, I think you now know your communication style. What I request you is to practice and make it better. Thank you, and over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Nivedita. Our third speech project by Toastmaster Sudha is being evaluated by Toastmaster Ramanand. May I request to Toastmaster Ramanand to present his report, please.
Thank you, General Evaluator Toastmaster Manish. Toastmaster Sudha, we all presume that you have a PhD on the subject of sustainable development. If not, you should definitely consider getting one. Let's look at the things that brilliantly worked in your favor. The first, you acted, or rather are, a subject matter expert on the topic or domain of sustainable development. Now, you very easily and aptly deciphered and decoded the various components of sustainable development, such as climate change, crime rate, and what we can do as a community to change that. Second, let's do a quick impact analysis on the crux of your speech and what we are taking away from it. I learned how to invest smartly and affect change positively. I learned the 5 P's of sustainable development, that is people, prosperity, how we should encourage global partnerships and peace, and overall, the measures that we can take to save the planet. Third, you informed us about the measures that the government and the UN is taking to try kind of turn all the negative effects of what has affected the world around. Now, third, which was the most important objective for your speech, was the Q&A session. Now, all throughout answering both those questions asked respectively by Toastmaster Manish and Toastmaster Babu, you appeared very calm and composed, and your answers were very clear and concise. Now, this just goes to show how in-depth knowledge you have about this subject, and you know about this domain very much thoroughly and all the ins and outs of it. Now, if you were to deliver this speech again or a similar kind of presentation, I have, in my opinion, two things that can take this a notch up. The first one is you could have made the start a little more vivid than by singing that song yourself instead of sharing it, and just keeping it to a minute or so that we have more time to address the important things, that is the crux of your speech, what you want to convey, and the Q&A session. Second, now we always see that an informational speech gets a little heavy on the content part. Now, what you could do overall is reduce a couple of slides, and in each of the slides that remain, take out a couple of pointers here and there, keep it a minimal two or three, so that overall the message that you're trying to convey is much more easier for the audience to grasp. All in all, a brilliant speech, well presented, well delivered. You seemed very comfortable all throughout. Just keep in mind that you can have a much more vivid start the next time by singing that song yourself and keeping it to a minute or so. Second, make it a little lighter on the content part so that it is much more easier for all of us to grasp. Looking forward to hearing more in depth about the subject of sustainable development from you. Over to you, Toastmaster Manish.
Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ramanan. May I request Toastmaster Ashish to present the timer's report for the evaluators?
Thank you, Toastmaster Manish. Toastmaster Babu has taken 5.18 minutes. Toastmaster Nivedita has taken 3.25 minutes. Toastmaster Ramanand has taken 3.02 minutes. So other than Toastmaster Nivedita, Ramanand are eligible for voting.
Okay. Mr. General Evaluator, I have a small request.
Yes, please.
This evaluation of mine was geared to the fact that Toastmaster Pragya is going to participate in a contest. So I went a little overboard to give her a little more feedback. So I suggest that, I mean, this is a submission, if you can get the voting for the other two evaluators who were within,
I mean, the time. When we have just two people, we cannot have a vote between two. So I would suggest we avoid a vote. Otherwise, you know, we need a minimum of three at least.
Okay.
Okay. So thank you, Toastmaster Ashish. May I request the R counter, Tina, to present her report for the meeting.
Thank you, Toastmaster Manish. Thank you, Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters and guests. I hope I was able to decipher the role of R counter and I have evaluated everyone fairly. Truly inspiring speeches by my fellow Toastmasters and lovely guests. My report goes as follows. TM Rajkaran, two crutch words are one filler so, two repeat words as a so so. Toastmaster Babu, four airs, one filler okay, two fillers so. Toastmaster Pratibha, three airs, one filler okay, two fillers so, one short pause, and five repeat words brain brain, VV, book book. Toastmasters, Toastmasters, Hume, Hume. Toastmaster Vasudev, four R words, two airs, and one repeat word, communication. Toastmaster Pragya, one filler, just, and two repeat words, seem, from. Toastmaster Sudha, 14 crutch words are seven airs, three ums, two fillers, okay, one filler so, three filler phrases, I mean, probably, I think, and six repeat words, start, basic, was, think, one, the, might. Toastmaster Ashish, 13 hours, Toastmaster Ankit, three hours, and one repeat word, definitely. Toastmaster Nivedita, 5 hours, and one filler, okay. And three repeat words, identify is and. Toastmaster Ramanand, 4 hours. And Toastmaster Manish, two filler phrases, honestly, I mean, this is for our Toastmasters. And I've also noted for the table topics, Toastmaster Sunil had 34 hours. He used four repeat words, good, looks like, from fillers, five and so but, and filler phrase one, maybe yes. Toastmaster Ronak, 12 hours, one repeat words one, that is really. Filler so, basically. Decipher was used by Toastmaster Sunil and Toastmaster Ronak. Toastmaster Manoj had 19 hours, two repeats, I, they, they. Filler two means, and filler phrases, but if. Toastmaster Srijoy had 23 hours, repeat were four, in, two, one, the. And fillers were because and but. And filler phrase was one. And last one is Toastmaster Varun. There were 11 hours and there was one filler and so. And filler phrases were three, is like, you like, you like. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Toastmaster Tina. That was quite exhaustive. May I request the grammarian, Toastmaster Chetan, to present his report.
Hello, hello. Am I audible now? Okay. Thank you, General Evaluator. I think the word of the day was used by five people: Toastmaster Sunil, Toastmaster Ronak, Toastmaster Manish, who is a General Evaluator, Toastmaster Ramanand, and Toastmaster Tina herself. And thanks for that. And so now a list of to me, the way I heard it, I believe that these were the incorrect use of those sentences. Could have said better. First one is, would you be scared? I think that in the context in which was used, wouldn't you be scared? Did you love him? Sort of that, didn't you love him? Second is, having spoken about, it should have been having talked about. Working professional, there's nothing like working professional. It's like out of my work experience or my profession. So you can say that. One fit for all, it should be one style fit for all. One has to be associated, the one word, it has to be associated with something, and then you say it. Strategies while reading, strategies to be applied while reading. Then third mutant, taking lives. Third mutant, responsible for many deaths, as you should have. Then transitions are made, and transitions were made. It should have been said that. And there are some good usage of English by many Toastmasters. I'm going to repeat some of them. I'm unmasked. Are you? Communication is like water, important in everybody's life. And also, the art of communication is the language of the leadership. Imagine yourselves in the mirror, but you can't see yourselves because you are wearing a mask. And lastly, you have to fake it till you make it. Over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Chetan. Now on to my report for the meeting number 338. We started at 5:30 sharp, which is a BTM standard. So kudos to the staff for sticking to the BTM standard always. The Sergeant at Arms, sorry. I mean, we should not be using acronyms. The presiding officer, as usual, his introductory message was very good. And he introduced the guests also. He gave them an opportunity to speak. So that was on track as well. The Toastmaster of the day, I must commend her for an interesting theme which was discussed with all in the meeting. Now, this was unique, as you know, we normally have the Toastmaster of the day talking about the theme herself, whereas in this case, she got the audience involved, which was very nicely done. So kudos to her for that. The timer, Ashish, first time. He's performing the role for the first time, I think. So congratulations, Ashish. You did a fabulous job. Very well done. Our counter, Tina, also, I think, was the first time. I'm not sure. Tina, was this your first time? Okay. Congratulations to you as well for that.
Thank you.
Just a couple of tips for you. You don't use the word TM. You call him or her the Toastmaster. We avoid using acronyms.
Sure.
And you had presented a detailed report, no doubt, but the word of the day report usage, you mentioned in one of the cases that word of the day was used by some people. So that is not your prerogative. That's a prerogative of the grammarian. So you have to avoid using that as the R counter. Grammarian Chetan, very nice job. One suggestion I have is that we are no one to say that this was incorrect. I would suggest you use the word not so good usage of the language, because there are chances. I mean, all of us make mistakes. So we are no one to say that you were incorrect. We would say not so good usage according to me. So, you know, we kind of providing a disclaimer. Toast Table Topics Master, Ankit, you had some excellent topics, no doubt. You introduced the, you know, the session very well in the form of short, you know, stories or piecing of the stories. One, you know, pet peeve I have is that the topics are long. You can curtail them because, you know, we should be thinking of the speaker, his listening skills, because you give a long topic, he probably gets distracted. And, you know, we have to repeat the topic twice. So I suggest keep the topic short, maybe 3 or 4 words at max, and try to fit in the topic in that way. So that will, you know, help the speaker develop his listening skills as well, not just his oratory skills, because he has to listen to your title very carefully and then begin to speak. Okay. Fine. Apart from that, I was very happy. I got to learn a lot of things, different books. Someone suggested to make me some books on chat as well. So I am going to look at them. And even someone suggested starting Harry Potter. So that is something unique. I mean, maybe I'll start. The happiest person on earth would be my daughter, because she talks a lot about Harry Potter and I really don't understand anything of what she's talking. But maybe, who knows, I'll start. But honestly, I'm not too much of a book lover. I don't read much. But yeah, so that concludes my report for the meeting. I would hand it over back to the Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Pratibha, to take over. Over to you, Pratibha.
Thank you, Toastmaster Manish, for that interesting General Evaluator's report. In fact, I really enjoyed today's meeting. The takeaway for me was that the books are just like good speeches. Some nurture the mind, some transform the life. And for book lover, what is more joy than to share about their favorite book? You must have seen today everyone's expressions and the enthusiasm to share about the book which they liked. I really loved the idea, how they shared. And I'm sure today we all will be having something in our mind to open one book at least and to read it. With those reading strategies, it will definitely help you. I'll be very happy if Bombay Toastmasters will open one book forum. Because we all are readers, all Toastmasters are readers. Let's try and we'll have definitely interesting segment to our club. With this, I'm happy to hand over it to presiding officer for his, yes, Toastmaster.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster of the day. I think you can count me in as the first member for the book forum. I have generally been a strong advocate of books, though these days I am sidelined by my family members, particularly my daughters, who swear by Kindle. And they in fact tell me that I am now too old fashioned to be sitting with books when everything is available on the internet and you can read everything on Kindle. So I told them that good luck to you. If you enjoy reading the Kindle, I am happier sitting cozily in on a bean bag or on a sofa with a snuggled with a book, you know, and enjoying the contents. So, so that debate goes on. And in fact, perhaps if we have a book forum, we can also have another debate on whether the spoken word is more impactful than the written word or vice versa. We can have a debate on this in maybe one of the future sessions. But having said that, I must say this was a fantastic theme which our Toastmaster of the day has come up with. I'm sure it will kindle some of us to go back to our books and enjoy the joy of reading, which I think this world seems to have lost to a great extent. So kudos, Pratibha, for having reinstilled and or rekindled those ideas. And let's give her a huge round of applause for this. Okay, now let's get to hear some of the views of our guests, especially those who haven't spoken. I see guest Ganesh. Are you there, Ganesh?
Yeah, I'm there.
Yes. Let's hear from you as to how you felt and what you felt about the session.
The session was good. I enjoyed very much. And thank you for having me on this session.
Yeah.
I learned so many things from you, from your expertise. And try to incorporate all those things in my personal life and try to improve myself more and more by joining your more sessions.
Oh, thank you. Wonderful, wonderful. Look forward to seeing you again. Guest Hitesh, let's hear about your views as well.
Thank you. Yes, I think the as spoken already, Pradeepa, fantastic topic chosen for the day, kept us all glued to the screen, and I was personally focused on opinions and books and whatever was coming on the chat as well. So it was very, very interesting. I loved the speeches. I think each one was incredible. I particularly liked and enjoyed the one with the mask. The evaluations were absolutely brilliant. Some of these were very exhaustive, but very informative as well. What Tina did was fantastic. I think, keeping a track of somebody for nearly 2 hours or speakers for nearly 2 hours and then, stating it out. I think that's the whole purpose. That's the spirit. You learn from a session like this. And I think it was incredible. I love the submission that Manish did in the end. I think, again, just highlighting even to the evaluators, what is it that they could do right or they could do differently, which will help boost confidence and participation from everyone else. I must be candid and confess that when the time for table topics came in, I was slightly hesitant and I did raise hand, but slightly later. I would make it a point that next time around, I volunteer first and get myself a chance to speak. That's exactly why I'm here for. And but all the topics and the way those were chosen and spoken were incredible. So thank you so much. Very engaging session.
Thank you, Mr. Hitesh. When you said that you were hesitant, I think you were being just normal, like all of us when we started our Toastmasters journey. But I'm sure that once you're in it, we will see a transformed Hitesh a few sessions down the line.
Thank you so much.
Any of the other guests would like to say a few words, Varun or Srijoy, or both of you?
Thank you for having me here. It was an enriching experience, I must say. I would say it's a part of a community learning. That's what I got to learn from here, that all of us are contributing to each other's, enhancing each other's capabilities and mentioning their pain points that we can work upon. And that goes a long way. And I look forward to joining these sessions again from the next week onwards. And thank you for having me. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Varun. Srijoy, maybe let's make it short. We're running out of time.
Thank you so much, Babu, and everyone else on this forum for allowing me to come on this in this meeting and talk to all of you and also contribute and participate. Special mentions to Tina for that incredible evaluation. I mean, I would have never thought that I used the 23 R's in any of my speeches. So, that's something that I'll take away from here. All the speeches were fantastic, very well delivered. Maybe one or two were a little over animated, but very well delivered nevertheless. The evaluations were really spot on, very very amazingly delivered as well. And what Varun said is exactly right. It's community learning, and that's I guess the way forward. So thank you very much. I'll keep it short and I look forward to being here again.
Thank you so much. And one final guest, though I wouldn't consider him as a guest, Ramanand, let's have a word from you and tell us about how you felt.
Thanks, Babu. It's always a pleasure coming back to Bombay Toastmasters, one of the elite that we have in Mumbai/Bombay. So thank always you. Happy to be a part of your meeting. Look forward to coming here again.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Okay, I think since we are racing against time, let me go on to the awards. We have two awards for the evening. The first one, yes, it should be the table topics. The award, the best table topic speech today was delivered by our guest, Srijoy. Please give him a huge round of applause.
Thank you very much, everyone.
Thank you so much. Now we'll take some tips from you.
Okay. Long way for that.
Okay. And the other award is, of course, for the best of Big Three. And this goes to the one who has rekindled the interest of books in us. Toastmaster, Pratibha Kamath. Congratulations, ma'am.
Thanks.
Good. So I think with that, we've almost come to the end. Yeah, I think Rajkaran has been pleading with us to switch on our videos for taking a snapshot. Rajkaran, have you taken already?
Yeah, it's already been done.
Already done. Okay, great.
Babu, I would like to request you to please call Sanchit and ask about his, because he's a new member.
Sorry.
Okay. Sanchit.
But he's a...
Yeah, he's our member.
Okay.
Let's have his feedback on
that. Yeah, sure. Okay, no problem. Yes, Sanchit, sorry. I think I should give you maybe the last word or last but one word.
Sure. So as always, I enjoyed this session as well. I learned a lot from the guests and all the role players. And the next meeting, I'll be playing some of the other roles. So I'm looking forward to that as well. Thank you for the interesting session.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sanchit. And I cannot but close the session without giving one, again, last but one word to a lady, our VP Education, Madam Toastmaster Nivedita, if she has anything to...
Thank you. I really don't want to take your time. We are already overshoot time today. Yeah.
In case you have any important announcements.
We have a meeting on 1st May and we have a joint meeting session on 8th May. So stay tuned for more details, but share your roles, speeches immediately for the 1st May session. Thank you and over to you.
Thank you so much. It's a good thing that the general evaluator doesn't come at this stage to tell us that you have overshot time like... But anyway, since I have the privilege of the last word, I'll say so long then. I think this session comes to an end, and I think all of us really enjoyed lovely speeches, good table topics, wonderful tag roles, especially a special word to our first timers, our counter Tina, and an excellent job, and of course everyone else. So with that, I think let's conclude it here, and wishing you all the best. Happy watching IPL, Indian Idol, or whatever you have, and have a great weekend. Thank you. If any of the guests want to stay back, they are welcome.
Thank you, Babu.